Welcome friends, hope you are fine. Today the topic which I select for you is anticoagulant. Anticoagulant. In this video we will talk about what is anticoagulant, what are the types of anticoagulant, what is the mode of action of anticoagulant, what are their uses. We will discuss about these topics. Anticoagulant is a substance which removes or inactivates any blood coagulation factor. Those substances which removes or inactivates any kind of blood coagulation factor, that substance is called anticoagulant. But remember one thing, that anticoagulant only delays coagulation. It is not permanently inactivates the coagulation. It only delays the time of blood to coagulate. There are many types of anticoagulant that are used, but we will discuss only three anticoagulants that are routinely used. One is sodium citrate, second one is EDTA, and third one is heparin. These three anticoagulants are widely used. First of all, we will discuss about sodium citrate. Its mechanism of action, then it removes calcium ion from blood. That is, it binds with calcium and does not allow any coagulation factor to coagulate the blood, because calcium ion is necessary for the coagulation. So what does it do? It removes calcium from the blood, and that's why it is used as anticoagulant. And how it is used? If we do for ESR, one part of sodium citrate, one part of sodium citrate is mixed with four part of blood. If we want to do ESR by Western Green method, then what will we do? We take one part of sodium citrate, which is enough for four parts of blood. But if we are checking the clotting mechanism, or we checking the clotting of blood, or we can say that for PT and APPT, then we take one part of sodium citrate, one part of sodium citrate with nine part of blood. Here you can see the difference, that for different tests, different parts of sodium citrate, or we can say that different gram of sodium citrate is used. If you do ESR, then one part of sodium citrate is enough for four parts of blood. And if we do clotting tests such as PT and APPT, then we take one part of sodium citrate and mix with nine parts of blood. We talk about ADTA. EDTA. Just like sodium citrate, it also removes calcium ion, removes calcium ion from the blood. And if we take powdered EDTA, then 2 grams of EDTA is used for 1 ml of blood, or we can say that 10% of EDTA solution is required for 5 ml of blood. If we talk about its merits and demerits, first of all, we talk about its merits. It is the best or commonly used anticoagulant. It is commonly used anticoagulant. It does not change morphology of RBC. Therefore, if we want to prepare smear of blood, then we can use EDTA because it doesn't change the morphology of red blood cell. Also, we can use it for HB, RBC count, TLC, DLC and PCB, etc. It also does not cause clumping of platelets. So these are merits, and if we talk about its demerits, then if we use excess of EDTA, excess of EDTA, which means that we have small volume of blood and large volume of EDTA, then it causes breakdown of platelets. And also it causes RBC to shrink. If RBC shrink, then PCV volume reduces. So this is the demerits of EDTA. And the last, we'll talk about heparin. Heparin is a natural anticoagulant. Only coagulant which is produced by your body. It is also produced commercially, but it is very expensive. Expensive. 20 units of heparin will enough for 1 ml of blood. Heparin is used in that cases where we require minimum hemolysis, such as if we want to do fragility test, or we can micro method of PCV. We can also use it for different chemistry tests, such as for glucose, for electrolyte check. We can also use heparin in biochemical test. In biochemical test, 2 mg of lithium heparin is used lithium, heparin use for 10 ml of blood. So guys, these are some coagulants, their uses, their mechanism of action, their merits and demerits, which we have discussed. Hope you like this video. If you like this video, then please like it, share it, and if you have any suggestions about this video, then you can comment it. So meet you inshallah in next video. Till then, goodbye. Allah Hafiz.